team of researchers just built a microchip that can learn by itself. Not learn as in run AI models. It literally modifies its internal structure to improve performance based on experience. It's called a self-learning memristor, and it might be the most brain-like piece of tech we have ever made. Today, I'm going to walk you through what this chip actually is, how it works, why it matters, and how it fits into the larger movement towards neuromorphic computing, hardware that mimics the brain. This isn't a theoretical leap, it's real hardware in the works, and it could mark a turning point in how we build AI systems. Let's start with the basics. A memristor is short for memory resistor. It's a fundamental circuit element first theorized in 1971 that changes its resistance based on the current flowing through it. But more importantly, it remembers that resistance even after the power is turned off. So it acts a little like memory, a little like logic, and a lot like a synapse. In a biological brain, synapses get stronger or weaker based on how often they're used. That's how we learn. A memristor does something very similar. It physically alters its conductance in response to electrical signals. That makes it a prime candidate for building artificial synapses in brain-like computers. Now, memristors have been built before, but until recently, they were passive components, holding weights for neural networks, not learning them. This changed with a 2025 breakthrough by a team at KAIST, the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology, working with collaborators at the University of Texas, Austin. What they built is more than just a memristor array, it's a self-learning chip, a 32 by 32 memristor crossbar array with learning circuitry baked in. In test, it was tasked with separating a moving object from a background in a video stream. At first, its output was noisy. Real memristors are analog and imperfect, but as the chip processed more and more frames, it improved, it corrected itself, and eventually its performance matched that of ideal digital simulations. This kind of on-chip, online learning has been a holy grail in neuromorphic hardware, and now it's been demonstrated. In conventional computing, memory and processing are separate. You fetch data from RAM, process it in a CPU or GPU, and write it back. This constant shuttling burns energy and limits speed. It's called the von Neumann bottleneck. Memristors eliminate that. Their resistance encodes weights. Signals flow through them and get scaled automatically. Computation and memory happen in the same place. Most of today's AI runs on GPUs. We train massive models in cloud data centers and then deploy them as fixed systems. If something changes, say, lighting conditions in a vision system, the model doesn't adapt unless we go to the back end and retrain it. That's inefficient, it's brittle, it's also incredibly power hungry. This memristor chip learns in place. It doesn't need to ship data to the cloud, it doesn't need massive data sets or retraining cycles. It's small, local, and adaptive. That could make a huge difference for edge computing. Think autonomous drones, medical sensors, or any AI that needs to run in the real world, in real time, with minimal power. Let's talk about what this could unlock. Imagine a smart camera that gets better at detecting motion over time, without needing retraining in the cloud. Or a wearable health monitor that learns your baseline and flags anomalies based on your unique patterns. Or an autonomous drone that refines its obstacle detection as it flies, adapting to new environments without draining a data connection. These are real applications that demand on-device learning, where privacy, latency, or bandwidth constraints make cloud-based AI impractical. This brings us to a deeper point, privacy and resilience. Edge AI, that is, computing done locally on the device rather than in the cloud, is becoming increasingly important, from autonomous vehicles to smart sensors, to industrial robots. We want systems that are fast, efficient, and independent. Self-learning chips like this memristor array make that possible. They don't need to send raw data back and forth. They can learn from the environment, adapt in real time, and do so without exposing sensitive information to external servers. That means greater privacy, lower latency, and less reliance on connectivity. In healthcare, that could mean real-time diagnostic tools that learn patients' patterns. In defense, it could mean autonomous systems that update themselves in the field. And in consumer electronics, it could mean phones, earbuds, and wearables that grow more personalized the longer you use them, without draining your battery or invading your cloud storage. As I mentioned earlier, the chip uses a 32x32 crossbar array. That's 1024 memristors wired into a grid. Inputs are voltages applied across rows and currents sum across the columns. It's performing matrix vector multiplication directly in hardware. Using the memristor's conductance as weight sounds like a lot like an Excel spreadsheet. But the key is learning. They implemented a local learning rule, kind of like Hebbian learning in neuroscience, that adjusts memristor conductance based on input signals and errors. That's not easy. Real memristors are non-linear. They vary from device to device. But the researchers embrace the analog messiness. They let the system calibrate itself over time. And it worked. This is what neuromorphic computing has been aiming for, at least for over a decade. Computation and memory in the same place, and real-time learning on the chip. This memristor breakthrough isn't happening in isolation. It's part of a broader movement in hardware neuromorphic engineering. The idea is to rethink how we build computers by looking at how the brain does it. IBM's True North chip packed 1 million digital neurons and 256 million synapses into a postage stamp size chip. Intel's Loihi chips use spiking neurons and local plasticity to support real-time learning. MIT built an analog synapse that switches 1 million times faster than biological ones. BrainChip is working on neuromorphic processes for edge AI with on-chip learning. What ties all of this together is a shift away from traditional computing architectures where memory and processing are separate, and towards integrated, adaptive, massively parallel systems, just like the brain. Why is this so compelling? First, energy. The brain runs on about 20 watts. A modern GPU may draw up to 400 to 1,200 watts each. For large AI workload, that adds up fast. Sometimes estimates say AI will consume 0.5% of global's electricity by 2027. Neuromorphic chips like this one operate in the milliwatt range because they process data where it's stored. They limit the bottlenecks of moving data. Second, adaptability. Traditional AI models can't learn continuously. They forget past knowledge when retrained. This is called catastrophic forgetting. And we all have some experience with this, lamenting the hours we spend going in circles with ChatGPT. Neuromorphic systems can learn incrementally over time without wiping out what they already know. Third, scalability. This chip is small, just over 1,000 memristors, but it proves the concept. Larger arrays integrated with sensors could enable full systems that learn on device continuously with high efficiency. Of course, there are still challenges. Memristors vary in performance. Their endurance, that is, how many times they can be reprogrammed, is limited. Manufacturing at scale with consistent behavior is hard, and the software stack for neuromorphic systems is still immature. We've had decades to optimize for CPUs and GPUs, but neuromorphic computing is just getting started. But that's changing. Research labs and chip makers are investing heavily in analog AI and in-memory computing. New materials are being tested, better learning algorithms are being developed, ones that tolerate analog noise and variability. And the urgency is real. As AI models grow larger and more widespread, the demand for efficient, adaptable, local learning hardware will only increase. This self-learning memristor chip might not be the brain in a box just yet, but it's a major step in that direction. It shows that we can build hardware that learns, adapts, and computes in fundamentally different ways from systems that we've relied on for the past 50 years. I'll give you one parting thought. You're probably switching this on a device that consumes 10 times the power of your brain just to stream video. Now imagine what's possible with the reverse.